Hello to all of you who are viewing. I will be teaching you how to process and analyze climate data in this lecture. Therefore, the most common method for processing and analyzing climate data are averaging, spatial temporal analysis, time stress trend analysis, extreme climatic event analysis, performance evaluation, anomalies, and coefficient of variation. Therefore, averaging, which is the process of calculating the mean values of monthly, seasonal, and annual climate and weather elements data, and analyzing the climate variation and its distribution in space and time within a specific region is the other most common method of analyzing both climate and weather data. ArcGIS and QGIS are the two examples of softwares that could be used for analyzing the spatial and temporal distributions of weather and climate data. Furthermore, various or different R program or software packages, including Sinus Slope Estimator, the Mankindle Trend Test Analysis, the Modified Mankindle Trend Test, and Innovative Trend Test, can be used to perform time stress trend analysis. And climatologists may also examine the frequency and severity of extreme weather events, which can be described by calculating different indices that are recommended by the expert team on climate change detection and indices, as well as the World Meteorological Organization. And performance validation and assessment are the other typical method for processing and analyzing both weather and climate data. It is well known that meteorological stations data is the most prevalent, significant, and actual or real form of climate and weather data. However, a number of studies have found that the most significant barriers in developing nations for meteorological stations are their shortcoming, which includes poor data quality, data discontinuities, uneven distributions of meteorological stations, its availability, as well as accessibility. But a lot of researchers now are using model data sets like global circulation model and regional circulation models, model data sets, and also researchers are using satellite-based data sets as an alternative source for meteorological stations data. These alternate sources of climate data still have issues with their scores, spatial and temporal resolution. Therefore, using different statistical indicators like correlation, root mean square error, and mean bias error, the capability of these data sets or these alternate data sets need to be assessed or validated and tested against the reliable observational data with a good spatial coverage. So, analyzing climate and weather variability by computing standardized anomalies and the coefficient of variation is another common method for analyzing both climate and weather data sets. So, in this video, I will demonstrate how to use Excel to calculate the standardized anomaly index as well as coefficient of variation. So let me briefly discuss the concepts of the tool. So okay, so the first one is coefficient of variation, which is a metric used to quantify variability that shows how much climate event deviates from the mean of the years it is analyze. So this coefficient of variation can be applied to analyze the variability of weather and climate data on monthly, seasonal, and annual time stresses. So The coefficient of variation can be found by dividing the standard deviation by the mean. Okay, so it can be calculated or obtained by dividing the standard deviation by the mean value of the time series data and multiplying it by 100. So variability can be categorized as less variable, moderately variable, and highly variable. It can be categorized as less variable if the result is less than 20%, moderately variable if the value of coefficient of variation is in between 20% and 30%, and categorized as highly variable if the value of coefficient of variation is more than or equal to 30%. So the standardized anomaly index is the second approach to calculate climate variability, and in this video I will demonstrate how to do it with Microsoft Excel. So the standardized anomaly index shows how far a climate event deviates from the mean of use it is analyzed by and by expressed in standard deviation. All right, in the case of rainfall data analysis, this standardized anomaly index is used to evaluate the frequency and severity of drought events, as well as it is used to identify the dry as well as wet years in the records. This can be computed by taking the rainfall value for that year and minimizing the long-term mean and dividing the result by the standard deviation. Thus, the outcomes of standardized anomaly index can be categorized as extremely wet, very wet, moderately wet, and normal, moderately dry, very dry, and extremely dry. So now let me demonstrate how to compute both of these methods for analyzing climate variability in Excel, which are coefficient of variation and standardized anomaly index. I therefore have a satellite monthly rainfall data for the past 10 years from 2011 up to 2020 for Addis Ababa. So variability can be examined for monthly, seasonal, or annual timescales, as I have previously stated. So let us now compute the rainfall data's annual variability. So calculating the mean and standard deviation is the first step. Standard deviation and mean. Okay, so click the equal sign here in order to calculate the standardized anomaly index, and and write STDEV and open bracket and select this annual time series rainfall data, which is from 2011 up to 2020, and hit enter. Okay, so the time series data standard deviation is as 216.55. So the next step is to calculate the rainfall data's annual time series average. So click the equal sign and open bracket here and type average. Okay, in the open bracket, and select the annual time series rainfall value from 2011 to 2020. Okay. And yeah, and hit enter to find the mean value. So 1109.56 is the mean value for the time series data. So now let us calculate the quotient of variation. So by dividing this standard deviation value to the mean value of this and multiplying the result by 100, we can now compute the coefficient of variation. So once more, hit the equal sign and open bracket and choose the standard deviations value and press the over sign to multiply it by 100. Divide it by to the mean value, which is this, and multiply it by 100 and hit enter. So now we have calculated the coefficient of variation, which is 18.085, and which is less than 20. So therefore, it can be said that Addis Ababa rainfall variability between 2011 to 2020 is less variable because the result of the coefficient of variation is less than 20. Okay, so the next technique to determine rainfall variability is to compute the standardized rainfall anomaly index. So here, there are mean and standard deviation values that were computed. So let me duplicate this here. Okay. Therefore, to calculate the standardized anomaly index, take this year's rainfall value and minimize the long-term mean, which is this. Okay. To do so, press the equal sign here and choose this and press the minus sign. Okay, and finally write the mean value, which is 1197.445. Okay, 1197.445, and hit enter. Okay, so we have calculated or minimized the mean value from this annual time series rainfall values. Okay. So after that, divide these values to the calculated standard deviation value, which is 116.55. So hit the equal sign and select this and hit the divide sign and write 216.5531 and hit enter. So we only need to drag to calculate the remaining years. Okay, so here, okay, wet years are indicated by a positive value, however the dry years are indicated by negative values. Okay. So I can also use a graph to display this standardized anomaly index value. in light of this, okay, let me copy this here over here. Okay, first, sorry. So now I'm going to draw a graph. Okay, select the year and the value of standardized anomaly index value, and insert recommended charts. Okay. Yeah. So, in light of these 3 years, which are six years, which are 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015, and 2016, and 2018, okay, have negative standardized anomaly value, which indicates that these years were dry years. However, the year 2017 and 2019 and also 2020 have value which is above zero, or which is a positive value, indicators wet season or wet years. Okay, all of this had to do with the video from today. Lastly, remember to subscribe to this channel. Doing so will boost my motivation for future crucial videos. Thank you very much for watching this video.